My name is Hannah Boyd, and I am a senior from Gossamer High School. And this is my poem entitled Mia. I never look at anyone like in public. The face staring back at me has no beauty, no features worth mentioning. My long brown hair that must be pulled into a ponytail, and my entire world shows up. The freckles that seem to multiply when I want to hide, but disappear when I want to be unique. And the eyebrows that I'd be put to perfection if I hadn't given up. Full body mirrors are even worse because the list of things I would change about myself seems to multiply. The figureless body that isn't the preferred hourglass, but more like the straightness of a pencil. Like the one I used to write down everything I would change. The stomach rolls that no one has seen, but that makes me feel the freshness of teen more than I can bear. And the long thin toes that gave me the nickname Monkey Toes, and the reason they no longer wear footsteps. They say any test is good test, but no one tells you that when you're neither gorgeous nor what society deems unattractive, you become a chameleon. What's to hide in the middle? I can't decide what's worse, the plainness on the outside or the pain on the inside. My brain is a mess of depression and anxiety. It's the same brain that told me that dying alone isn't only a possibility, but my future. But it's amazing that I have friends at all. So why do I think anyone could ever chase away my loneliness? I spend hours in my room trying to figure out how long this poison has controlled me. Has it been simple months? Or you? The more I think about it, the more I realize it could have been at least a decade. They say pain is relative, but if that were true, why do they make me feel so bad for the things that I feel? Like, because to them, my life seems easy on the outside, I can't be struggling on the inside. When people ask me why I don't talk to them, the answer is simple. I can't even explain what's going on in my head. So how could I explain it to another person? Everywhere you see stories of people who fought depression, those who won their battles and those who didn't. But no one tells you what weapons should be in your arsenal, so you don't lose your battle. This isn't a fairy tale. This is my life. There's no magic mirror on the wall telling me I'm the fairest of them all. It's just me. Maybe one day things will get better. But even I can't. What I do know is the reflection you see in your mirror is not your end, but the story of the things that made you stronger. Depression is a one-way mirror that I would break, but I can't afford 7 more years of my life.